July 15th, the year of our Lord 2012. Carly Rae Jepsen's Call Me Maybe is the biggest song in the country. Ice Age Continental Drift is currently ruling the box office, and the New York Times was writing headlines about how to make friends in your 30s. All of these things pale in comparison to one of the most important cultural landmarks of this decade that was released on that fateful day. Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style changed the world, and that is no exaggeration. Today I want to take a step back and look at the impact of this ridiculous, amazing song and music video. So when this track was released, it went to the top of the South Korean music charts immediately, but that wasn't surprising at all. The musician behind the song was South Korean rapper Psy, whose real name is Jae-sang Park. He had been a prominent chart-topping musician within his native country for well over a decade, so huge, successful songs were not new to him. But success in South Korea was all they expected. There had already been attempts at Korean music crossing over into the US with K-pop groups like Girls' Generation and Wonder Girls. Marketing executives were doing everything they could to grow K-pop in the United States. They tried making English language songs and collaborating with Nickelodeon, but it wasn't catching on. And then, through sheer word of mouth, Gangnam Style starts to go viral. Psy was in many ways the opposite of these extremely polished girl groups. He proved that you didn't need to be young, pretty, and skinny to have an Asian song succeed worldwide. Some of the initial heavyweights that helped push the music video in the States were people like T-Pain and Britney Spears, and then pretty soon, it caught on like wildfire. People were attracted to this extremely catchy song, and even more so, the silly, bold, and in-your-face music video. The world was due for a great new learn-it-yourself dance craze. It was a perfect storm to make one memorable, explosive, viral video. We saw tutorials of how to do the dances in the video, Minecraft parodies, guest appearances on daytime TV, bride and groom first dances at weddings, tennis matches, football games, and so much more. Within the same year that it was uploaded, it became the most viewed YouTube video of all time, the first YouTube video to hit 1 billion views, and 2 years later, it was the first video to hit 2 billion views as well. The likes of See You Again and Despacito eventually overtook Gangnam Style, but we're not finished talking about this song's legacy just yet. Have you ever seen a more electric crowd than this stadium of 80,000 people singing and dancing in unison to this song? That's hard to beat. In Korea, Psy is regarded as a hero of sorts. Gangnam Style is a source of pride for the country because for a while, a K-pop rap song was ruling the world. So what better way to honor the man than with a giant statue of his hands mid-pony dance? And whether or not Psy is the musician that broke the barrier for K-pop being more normalized worldwide, that's up for you to decide. All I'm gonna say is that following Gangnam Style's most prominent years, searches for K-pop on YouTube tripled. In recent years, you have boy bands like BTS, who by the way also never expected to make it outside of South Korea, and they're beating out Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez at the Billboard Awards. One of my favorite quotes about Psy is from Bernie Cho, the president of a Korean music company. Psy proved to critics and pundits alike that just being a 100% Korean version of himself was the real secret sauce to international success. He wasn't Korea's Usher, Britney Spears, or Justin Timberlake. He was just Korea's Psy. When you look back at all the success and the accolades of Gangnam Style, there's one strange exception. The song was never a Billboard number one hit. It was clearly the biggest song in the world, but Billboard did not include YouTube views in the equation. So in October of 2012, the highest Gangnam Style ever got on the Billboard charts was number 2, behind Maroon 5's One More Night, which is obviously a travesty. I don't remember One More Night whatsoever. And guess what? Shortly after, Billboard started including YouTube views within its algorithm because of Psy. So whether it be the record-breaking stats on YouTube, the worldwide dance craze, the giant statue of Psy's hands, the rise of K-pop, or this one song changing how music statistics are calculated, it's safe to say that Gangnam Style changed the world. Hey, thank you for watching that video. I don't really know why I thought of making a Gangnam Style video in 2019, but here we are. If you liked it, feel free to like, comment, subscribe. That stuff helps the channel. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at RenshawHS, buy my merch, support my Patreon, and thank you very much. I'll see you soon.